there is a new super powerful development platform for blockchain. Until recently, it was reserved only for top blockchain companies, but they finally opened up to the public. This is a game changer for blockchain developers. If you want to stay relevant, you have to learn this tool. Alchemy API is a supercharged version of Infura with a very reliable and scalable Ethereum node API. Smart contract monitoring, smart contract debugging, webhooks, and many other cool stuff. In this video, I give you a quick tour of the platform and show you how you can use it to boost your development workflow. Very, very important, if you register a free or paid plan on Alchemy API, make sure to use the affiliate link that I put in the description. If you ever spend money with them, they will give me some money. I appreciate your support on that. And if you don't know me, I'm Julian, and on my channel EatTheBlocks, I teach DeFi, blockchain development, and how to find your first blockchain job. To get started with Alchemy API, you go to the website and you create a free account. At some point in the signup process, they're gonna ask you for your credit card, but this is optional, you can skip it. And after, when you open up your dashboard, is what you're gonna see. So in order to use Alchemy, you need to create apps. So for each app, you can define a couple of things like the environment, the development, staging, or production. And you also need to configure a specific network for each app. So you can configure it for mainnet, the production network of Ethereum, or the main public testnet like Kovan, RingB, etc. And if you want to create a new app, you go in the app menu, create app. So next, once you have created your app, you can access the dashboard specific to your different app here. So for example, if we go in test, for each app, you're gonna have a couple of URL, an HTTP URL and a WebSocket URL. And with these URLs, you can access Alchemy Supernode. Alchemy Supernode is an API that gives you access to an Ethereum node, a little bit like Infura. However, there are a couple of differences. First, Alchemy is super reliable. So typically, when you want to have a scalable infrastructure in web development, you have what we call a load balancer that balances incoming requests across different servers that are exactly the same. So this works well for traditional web development. However, in the context of blockchain, the problem is that your different Ethereum node might not be synchronized exactly the same way. So if you do this, sometimes you're gonna have some inconsistent data. So Alchemy developed a system to give you consistent data for every request. The other thing that is unique to Alchemy API is that this supernode is infinitely scalable. So if you have a surge in the traffic of your decentralized application, Alchemy API is able to handle your surge in traffic. So with Alchemy supernode, you have a limit usage. And in your dashboard, you can see how many requests were above this rate limit. So this is restricted first in terms of what they call compute units. So this is a number that they assign to each API call. For example, if you send a transaction, this is a certain number. If you just read data, this is another number. This is a little bit similar to gas cost, but for the API. And I also have a number of concurrent requests per second. I think this is 30 requests per second maximum. So it's important to protect your URL because here you have an API key that can be used by other people. So if you go in edit app, you can restrict the access. So if you use the Alchemy API from a frontend, that means that the connection URL will be visible by everybody. So anybody can just copy paste the API key and start to deplete your usage quota. So in that case, you can whitelist your application by adding its URL here. But keep in mind that this is not a foolproof solution because a data mine attacker can just modify the referer HTTP header. That's what we call spoofing the header. And second case, if you use Alchemy API from a backend application, in that case, you can whitelist the IP of your server, and in that case you are perfectly protected. It's not possible to spoof an IP. Okay, so that's it for the main feature of Alchemy API. Next, I'm going to show you the suite of monitoring tools. So when you maintain an application in production, it's always important to monitor your application to make sure that everything works fine. Otherwise, as the saying goes, if you don't measure it, you can't fix it. So here in the homepage of your dashboard, you can have a high level view of your different application and the number of requests and the median response time. So if you can see that it starts to take too much time to send responses, that might be a clue that something is wrong. And then if you go to the dashboard of a specific app, for example, the demo app, so here you will see again some of these metrics, as well as the proportion of successful requests and invalid requests. So if you can see that invalid requests are going up, that might be a sign that something is wrong. And if you scroll down, you can see more details. So here we don't have any data, but here you're supposed to see a table with a list of the different API calls that your application sent. So for each row, you can expand it and see the detail of each request. You can see the response time, the error code, if any, and you can also see a list of invalid requests, as well as requests that were rate limited. And if you scroll down, you can see some graphics. So here, the number of daily requests. And after, you have a map with the breakdown of requests per country. So that's very useful to know where a user come from. And here you have a map, especially for the US. Here you also have a live stream where you can see in real time what are the requests that are being sent from your app, and here a list of most active country. Okay, so monitoring is very important, and at some point in the life cycle of your application, you're probably going to stumble upon some errors. And when that happens, you need to do some debugging. And for that, Alchemy API also provides some nice tools. The first debugging tool we're going to see is the Explorer. So with the Explorer, you can explore all the API calls that were made from your account. That's similar to the table we already had in the app dashboard, but here you have more filtering options. So for example, we can choose to filter all the API calls for the last day. So let's see if we have something. Okay, last 10 days, we should have something. Yes, we do. So you can also scope the search result to a specific app. And here you can filter all the API calls that was success, or client error, server error, rate limited. You can also filter by error code, also by API call. And so for each API call, you are able to expand it and see the details. So the row request, the parameters, the response. And there is a filtering option that is pretty cool here. You can explore the similar API calls. So that can be very useful if you are investigating the cause of an error. So with this, you can figure out a pattern in the error. Okay, so that's one very useful tool. Another one is the Composer. So that's a visual interface to send requests to your Ethereum node. So here you can choose the network, then which API of Ethereum you want to hit. Then here you give the parameter of your request. You can also specify a specific block number you send the request, and you will see the response. So for some API call, this can be very useful. For example, if you want to know the gas price, but for everything where you have to interact with a smart contract like ETHCall or ETHSEND transaction, this is not very user friendly because here you have to deal with hexadecimal, same thing for ETHCall. So that would be more useful if Alchemy API used the same kind of visual interface offered by Etherscan. So if you go to Etherscan, you can put the address of smart contract and it dynamically create a visual interface with button for each function of your smart contract. So maybe that's going to be an improvement in the interface of Alchemy later. And another tool you can use to debug is the mempool. The mempool is a list of transactions that were not mined yet. We call this transaction pending. The mempool is part of an Ethereum node. Usually with other Ethereum APIs like Infra, you don't have access to this mempool. But with Alchemy API, you do. One case where it can be especially useful is when a user sends a transaction and doesn't see the confirmation in Etherscan. So then you can inspect the mempool and see, for example, that his or her transaction is pending, or even after a certain number of time, if the gas price was too low, the transaction can actually be dropped from the mempool. That can be very useful to give some feedback to users. And talking of giving feedback to user, we can use another tool of Alchemy, which is called Notify. So the next tool I want to show you is Notify. So with Notify, you can create webhooks that are triggered when a certain event happens on the Ethereum blockchain. For example, whenever a certain address sends or receives Ethereum or any token, you can create a webhook. So you specify the app, the webhook URL. So that's the URL that's going to be triggered when the event happens on the Ethereum blockchain. So typically, this is an endpoint of your application, but it can also be an endpoint of any other application. And below, you specify which Ethereum addresses need to be monitored, and you can add several addresses. You click on create webhook, and after to test your webhook independently of what happened on the blockchain, you can click on the test webhook button. That's super convenient. So there are other kind of webhook you can create. So for example, when a transaction was dropped, and you can see the format of the payload. So here you have the type of webhook with the detail of the transaction. So typically you would use this webhook to show some feedback to users. So this will hit an endpoint in the backend of your application, and this endpoint can be connected to the frontend of your user with a WebSocket, and you will inform the user that his or her transaction has failed. And you can have a similar setup for mine transaction. And here again, you can see the format of the payload with a different webhook type and all the details of the transaction. Another use case for this webhook is to send some emails either to you or to the user. And there are still many other possibilities. Okay, so next I want to talk of a very useful library that was created by the team of Alchemy. That's a modified version of Web3 called Alchemy Web3. To connect to your Ethereum node on Alchemy, you can use the Web3 library exactly like you would do for Infra. But there is an even better option. The team of Alchemy created a wrapper around Web3 for easy integration with their API. This is a drop-in replacement for Web3, so it has exactly the same base API as for Web3, so you don't need to relearn a totally different library. The only thing that is a little bit different is the way you instantiate Web3. You can see the details on their NPM package. There are a couple of advantages compared to basic Web3. First, it does automatic retries if a request fails because of a rate limiting error. Then it has improved WebSocket support. So if your WebSocket get disconnected, which can happen often, Alchemy Web3 will make sure that you don't miss any events when you get reconnected. And lastly, with Alchemy Web3, you can easily access some of the enhanced Alchemy API. So these are some convenience APIs for very common use cases, like getting the metadata of a token or getting token balances. If you need to dig deeper into Alchemy API, I recommend to check out their official documentation. And if you still have some questions, you can reach their support on their Discord channel, on Telegram, or for urgent requests, you can also create support tickets. So you can get started with their free plan. This will give you access to most of their features. However, keep in mind that if you need to use their auto-scaling feature, you will pay for the scaling that you will need. If you take the gross plan at $50 a month, it's going to unlock some extra features. For example, you have some extra endpoint to do some advanced debugging. You can also manage 15 apps instead of just 5 for the free plan. And your rate limit is also higher. And after that, if you have some really advanced need, then you can check out the enterprise plan, but this is customized. You have to see with a salesperson. Like I said at the beginning of the video, if you want to create a free or paid plan on Alchemy, make sure to use the affiliate link that I put in the description, because if you ever spend money with them, I will get paid by Alchemy. I really appreciate your support on that. And if you want to keep learning about blockchain development tools, I have a playlist on this topic on my channel. I'll see you there.